All right, so I'm going to do a match breakdown. I don't usually do match breakdowns on matches that I lose, because that's kind of sucky, but it doesn't really matter. This is for your benefit. So this is when I faced Gordon Ryan. I think this was 2014 or 15. I can't remember. I think it was before Abu Dhabi, the one that I won, and after the trials. This was an invitational from Grappler's Quest. And I had beaten the first guy, and I kind of started to hear about Gordon Ryan. He wasn't obviously the name he is today, but people were talking about him. He was a purple belt, but he was tapping black belts. He had already tapped a couple of the black belts before me on this one. So I kind of gave him a little respect, but not really, because he was just a purple belt in my head. But little did I know that he was going to be as good as he is. I knew after this match, but before the match, I didn't know that. So let's take a look. So he pulls guard right away, and I'm just looking to grab his ankles, pin them down, and come around or throw them to the side. And his strategy was just to keep backing up, and then as I walked, he would try to shoot in on a leg. This was more when Gordon just went for a lot of leg locks on people. He did some back take stuff too, but everybody knew that, you know, the Danaher guys, this is when Eddie Cummings was really big and people were just going for leg locks. So I was thinking about my legs and being careful and not to let him get too far under me. But his strategy was to keep backing up, and then shoot in. And I grabbed an ankle, and as I grabbed an ankle, he was shooting his legs deep, and he wants to get his grips. So I could tell he wants to lift me for the single X, so I keep my feet together, and I lean to the side he's trying to get single X to, and I tried to backstep. I do a lot of backstep passing, and it saved me on that one, because he wasn't able to get this leg underneath me. And then he goes back to guard, and he's trying it again. So I want to just basically get the space back, and he's trying to lift me up. And he's good with the grips. One thing I remember thinking was, man, he's got some pretty strong grips. He did those double grips here on my wrist, and it took pretty much everything to rip out of that. And I was like, okay, I don't want him to grip me like that. So again, I'm looking to step in the middle of him, knee cut through, snap his head down into a front headlock, anything I could do. Every time I'd go for his head, he'd shoot back. I have a guillotine that I wanted to try, but he wasn't letting me get his neck. And this is, I believe, is an 8-minute match with a 2-minute overtime. No points in the first 8 minutes, submission only, and in the last 2 minutes there was points. So again, I'm trying to slide through, create some kind of action. I know he wants the one thing, the leg lock, but I'm trying to avoid that. And this is, I mean, I work a lot more leg locks now, especially after this match, but I wasn't working a whole lot of leg locks at this point. Not a whole lot of people were. I mean, it was just starting to become more popular then, and now it's just crazy. But I think the Danaher guys made it re-popular again. So now I have a knee in. I'm finally in a passing position, or at least one where I can get started with the pass. He's got the knee shield, and again, these grips, these double grips he did, I remember thinking, man, I cannot rip my hand out. It's crazy. So I had to basically get up and use my body to rip out, and so that's what I did. And just trying to keep him away long enough to not elevate me and to try to work a pass was really, really difficult, because he's good at getting under. And I know what he wants. He wants to get this leg in for single X, so every time he tries that, I try backstepping over into a half guard or something, and it was working for the time, and he's trying to pull my wrist up over his head, and again, another back step. And now, here's where I feel like I'm pretty good with the back step twisted half guard. But what he ended up doing, so right here, I usually either hang on to the neck and see if I can get my left underhook under here and go for that exorcist choke, which is basically a one-arm guillotine, or just try to get my left arm underneath this leg and try to pass. But what he was doing really well was framing his arm under my throat to get his head free from my twisted half. And then once he did that, he went for a pretty slick back take, which I tried to reverse. So this is a pretty cool transition, so we'll show you this a couple times. And this is how I got my back taken. So again, I tried to go here to try to get his head caught, but instead of him having the underhook, which is what I want, because I want to Kimura it or, you know, control it, he pulled his arm out of here, and he's going to reach for my far hip, and he's going to try that slick back take where he pulls his bottom knee out. and just come around to the back. So I started feeling it because I have a guy here at the gym who does this. His name is Josh Best, one of my black belts. He does this a lot to me. So as I felt him coming up to take my back, I was like, you know what? Our legs are intertwined perfectly. I'm going to try to retake his back and do a rolling back take. So as you know, if my right leg's intertwined with his right leg, I could roll towards his feet over my right shoulder and pull him up, and you're into that truck position, you know, or a back take. So I had to do it really quickly because he was already sliding out to take my back. And I'll show you in real speed what it looked like. He kind of reversed it on me, shrimped out in reverse. So boom, I'm taking his back. Now boom, he's taking my back. And I tried to not let him get that second hook, but man, he slipped that in pretty quickly. So check it out again, it's pretty cool. So I feel him coming out to take my back. So I do a rolling back take of my own. And as I go to roll to take his back, see, I'm gonna pull this leg up with me right here. And I know he feels, because we actually talked about this after, he felt I was taking his back. And I remember him saying something like, man, I think I'm about to get my back taken. So what he had to do, so right now, if I can just keep climbing, there's his back. And if I can keep pushing his leg down. But what he did is he stopped it right there. And then he shrimped his hip out. And we're in the same position. So whoever has that angle of the shrimp is going to get the back take. So he had a lot more experience with this position than me, I guess. And he rolled me right back. And now my back's exposed. And I knew, I felt him climbing on my back. So I want to get this hip down to the floor. But instead of getting the hip down to the floor, he was really good at getting that hook in before I could do that. See, I roll, and I still trying to get this hip down to the floor, but this foot just shoots right over really fast and goes in. Boom, he's got my back. And I'm trying to, he didn't have the harness, so I was trying to get my back to the floor quick before he controlled me. And I got a hook out, and he's got my arm trapped, which is not good, but I'm still just trying to shrimp, get my back to the floor, and boom. Once the body triangle's locked in, I knew I was in for a long day. So if you look at the time, 3:43, he has full control of the back. I think he had it for like 4 minutes or 3 or 4 minutes. It's just a lot of grip fighting. He's trying to crush my face. He's trying to go. I'm trying to get my back to the floor. I'm controlling hands and just trying to survive. You know, he wasn't squeezing too tight here, which I was surprised. Because usually when I take the back, I'm trying to melt people. But I think he was just conserving energy because this is only the quarterfinals, I believe. So he's doing just enough to control me. See how light it was here? So he undid it. My mistake is I didn't realize it. I should have just tried to pop out when he did that. But I'm trying to work the hands. And now I got my back completely to the floor. But again, he'll squeeze when he needs to keep that hip square and not let me turn my hips into him. But as long as I'm here, I'm not getting choked. He was thinking about the Kimura, I think, for a second, or just trying to rip my grip off. But I have pretty strong grips as well, so I'm just trying to keep my back on the floor. And I know as long as I'm there, I'm safe from the attacks. But he wants to pull me back on and get back to my back. And again, with the body triangle, it's so hard to keep your back on the floor, and it's so hard to turn your hips into him, which is what I was trying to do. And he has long legs, so even if I was trying to put pressure here on his ankles, it's not going to work with someone with thinner, longer legs like myself, because when I do this to people, it doesn't really bother me. When Wagner does this to people, it doesn't really bother him when people start looking for leg locks on there. So again, I don't want his harness on me. I want him to try to come up to mount, because I feel like I'd have an easier time escaping the mount. Or while he tried to come up to mount, I would try to shrimp and elbow escape out. And he's looking up at the time. Looks like we're 5:20 into an 8-minute match. It's no point, so obviously we're both just trying to get a submission. But 3:04, so we're almost 2 minutes into his back control, and he looks like he wants to come up to mount with the body triangle. So I'm thinking about trying to just blast into his guard right now, but he has a good post right here, which is keeping me down. And he's trying to come up into a mount, and I just want to spin hard, but he's got a good hold of my hip with his body triangle. And there it is. So I felt a little better here. I don't mind being mounted with him with his legs like that, because there's no arm bar as long as his legs are locked. And, you know, he could probably gift wrap me and retake my back, but it's kind of where I just was. So I'm just thinking, okay, once he opens those for anything, I'm going to try to shrimp out and get my elbow escape. He may be thinking, hey, let's do this to try to re-get a back take with the gift wrap, but And I'm just conserving some energy. You know, I was using a lot of energy to try to get out of there, so I'm trying to breathe a little bit. He's breathing a little bit. And there's really not much attacks he can do here. So I'm sure he wants the gift wrap so he can retake the back, establish the back position again, which is fine. I'm going to wait for that and see if I can come out in the process, which he opened for a second. I try to come out, and here we are again, back on the back. So I feel like I conserved a little bit of energy now. Now I'm going to try to make a bigger attempt. But as long as that, I'm telling you guys, as long as that body triangle is locked, and he has a very good body triangle. The only other guy that I felt with a body triangle as good as Gordon's was probably Wagner when I trained with him. So they both have really good body triangles. But now it's open, so I'm like thinking, okay, I know what he's trying to do. We do this all the time. He's trying to get a hold of my arm. But while he's doing that, the body triangle's open, right? So before he relocks this in and traps my arm forever, I knew that was my chance. I had the energy conserved, try to get my back down to the floor while the guard is open, while the body triangle's open, and try my best to shrimp out and spin out, maybe spin into his guard. But he's got my arm trapped now. So now I'm in a little bit more trouble than I was before, but he doesn't have the control. So look, I was able to slide out, get my back to the floor, shrimp, shrimp, shrimp. I know he doesn't have any body lock now, so now I know it's a matter of time before I can get back to a guard. And there it is. So I'm back to open guard now. I want to get up. Right here, I wanted to get up. I felt like I could take him down, put him back on his back, or I felt like he would have pulled guard. So I'm really trying to get up, but he used the extra energy and effort to rush me down and keep me on my back. And now he has more of like a float position, and he's looking to pass. But I think that's before he was doing much float stuff, so I don't think he was that good at it at the time yet. And I'm just trying to get some space, try to get my legs back on the inside. He's trying to push them out. And time's almost up. I think there's 30 seconds left, maybe a little more. I think there were some ads before this, and he's fixing his tape. I want to take advantage of that. but I'm just trying to get my legs on the inside. It's all I'm really trying to do is get my legs back to the inside where he can't pass. There's a delaheva I have here, so maybe there's a sweep, but I want to get back to the butterfly so I can go inside of his, and he's just trying to get his knee cut through. And we're both trying it. So it's just Will versus Will. And now he's in a knee shield position. I have the what we call the goofy guard hook or the half butterfly. But he keeps disengaging to try to get space and try to pass. And it looks like we're coming off the mat. So we reset in the beginning. And I can't get anything going. He's pummeling. And I don't do leg locks much anyway, especially back then. So I'm just trying to look for a good position to come up to sweep. And now he's got me here. And he's looking to pummel through. And I'm trying to come out the back door. Didn't let me. And here we are. Back in the float position. He's trying to use this foot, I guess, to pin that down. But I'm pushing away. Trying not to let him pass. Trying to get up. Because I want to get up on top. Front headlock. Something. And this bottom stuff's not working. So again, he's driving me off the mat here. And here I did have a front headlock. Unfortunately, we had to stop. Oh, okay, so they let me reset with the front headlock. And I feel pretty good here, but he immediately shot this leg through. And usually I backstep pass from there, which I did. So we're creating a nice little scramble here in the last minute. I want to spin around to the back, which I almost did. And he scrambled nicely and almost reversed it. And then I tried to reverse it back, get back on top. That was a pretty cool scramble. So let's see that. So basically it's me trying to pass and him trying to get back to a guard from the front headlock. This is one of my better positions, the front headlock. I like to go here a lot. And I'm passing again and he's getting his legs in again and again. It could be he was trying to do the same back take he did before, but this time I was like, I'm not gonna do the twisted half guard this time because that's how I got my back take. I'm gonna stay square. So I stayed square and now I'm in his guard. We're both a little tired. I mean, I'm definitely not as energized as I was in the beginning of the match. He seemed fine, but definitely wasn't coming at me as much as he was in the beginning of the match. We are almost 10 minutes in. And I'm trying to knee cut through. Knowing what I now know, I'd probably try to go to the float as well, try to stop his single X from coming through. And now he has a butterfly guard. and I don't have as much energy as I had in the beginning, so it's a lot harder to stop his single X attempts. But I'm doing my best, keeping in the middle, head in the center, not letting him lift me, thinking about which pass I'm going to do next and how I'm going to get around this guard to try to get a submission, because, again, there's no points. So he goes to the single X, and I remember thinking, okay, I'm in my first leg lock 9 minutes in. This is not good. Danaher guy who, you know, is good with leg locks. And he hooks the heel. And I didn't know, like what I know now, like to turn the heel in or try to get back to my feet. So the only thing I knew back then was just to spin out and keep spinning and ripping my knee out, spinning, ripping my knee out. And as you see, the knee line is getting cleared. It's not as much under his armpit anymore. And the knee is starting to slide, and I was able to kick free. But that's not going to help me for too long. He wanted to get back on top, and he does. So that would have been a sweep in a real match with points, but no points. He's back in his flow position. I'm trying to get my left leg back over, and he's starting to go into a honey hole, which I didn't even know existed back then. And he's looking for it. I'm keeping that foot hooked just out of instinct, I think. If I come up, I could have some kind of a leg drag pass. But looks like time's going to expire here in a second before he gets to a full honey hole position. But yeah, I'm pretty screwed here once he gets to this position, but luckily the time ran out. See, now he switches it into a honey hole. Boom. And I'm thinking he's just backstep passing because that's what we all did back then. And luckily, time ran out. So round two, 2 minutes, points now. So I'm thinking, okay, points. I had a minute rest. Feel decent, nothing crazy. I'm not fully energized, but I feel okay. And I'm thinking I got to get my 2 points or 3 points for the pass. So I'm looking for a pass. I want to get that. I know he was going to be hard to submit or even hard to get position on, so I'm going to do my best here to pass. And it's like sucks losing to a dude with a duck on his shirt too. Like the whole time I was looking at that, like that would suck to lose to a kid with a duck on his shirt. Yeah, Eddie Cummings and Gary Tone coaching him. You know, this is 2014, so they were starting to really emerge as the guys. So again, back to the center. I know he wants that leg lock position again because he had it at the end of the round. I don't want to let him get it. And then he did something pretty slick where he's still trying the single X. I keep backstepping, so I'm avoiding it. I want to kick this leg free from the hook. I get back on, I turn my heel back in, and he's trying to push me down for single X. I'm trying to stay on top, and he gives up on it. But what he does here is something these guys are popular for doing today, which is locking up this shoulder and going for the Marcelo sweep. And I call it the Marcelo sweep because that's the first guy we've all seen do it, you know, throughout the early 2000s to people, or late 2000, 2008, 9, things like that. They lock up the shoulder and butterfly sweep you over. So I knew this one because I worked this a lot, because I worked a lot with Marcelo back then. So I knew he was going for that. So my left foot based out, and very cool transition. I base out my left foot because I don't want to get swept. And there's the foot. And then he's like, screw the arm, I'm going back to the leg. So that's how he got his single X in. Really nice. My knee's on the floor, but I'm still hooked. So I thought, well, my defense at this point is to spin out again, so let's see what happens. So watch my knee line, one spin, two spin, and every spin I do, I'm trying to kick the butt and rip my knee free. And as you see, it's starting to come out. He's starting to lose it here. One more spin and we start to run off the mat. But I see, as you see, my knee is pretty much clear. He doesn't have a good bite on the heel anymore. It's pretty much pressed against his chest, but we had to stop. And I feel like if there was one or two more spins, I would have been out. But there was not. So we reset in a heel hook, which is never good with, you know, the guys that are good with heel hooks. And he's got a nice, good, tight, you know, single X. His butt's nice and close to mine. He's in there. And I'm thinking I'm pretty screwed, but I'm going to give it my best. And he went to the double outside, came up. I'm thinking I gotta just try to rip out, do something. I turn one more time, and when I landed, he got a really good hook, and he got it. I'm not breaking my knee. So that was the match, which brought him on to the semis against somebody, I forget, and then the finals against Dan Martinez. And then he ended up beating Dan. And now he's Gordon Ryan. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope you learned something from it. After this, I started working more leg lock defense, and it's actually helped improve my game a lot. So hope you liked it. See ya.